calm down.
What's up, Money Geeks? Mr. V here. Welcome to another video, guys. So in this video, I want to talk about some stocks that I'm actually looking at and I'm adding to my position with some of these companies. And a lot of these companies are companies I've actually covered here on the channel. But when I saw this opportunity with this pullback, and I'm adding more to my position because these are not companies I'm swing trading or I'm actually looking at maybe day trading. No, these are companies that I'm looking 5-10 years down the road. So again, during this period, when I see the opportunity to add, I'm actually jumping in and adding to my position. So that's what I want to cover in today's video. But before we get started, guys, if you're new to the channel, we talk about how to earn money, how to save money, how to invest and build wealth. So if that's something that interests you, go ahead and hit that subscribe button and the notification bell so you don't miss out on new content. So when it comes to the stock market pulling back, there's usually two kinds of people, right? There's people that panic and sell, or there's people that look for opportunities and buy. Again, so when you look at the people that panic and sell, you can tell that these are people that haven't been in the market for a long time. And then we look at the people that are looking for the opportunities to buy. You know, these are people that have been around because they know how this thing works. The market goes in waves. People are used to just getting green. They're not used to the red. So when they see the red, they panic a lot. So again, I'm right now in the position where I'm looking for opportunities. When I see the market in this kind of a situation, I'm excited because it gives me an opportunity to load up on my long-term position. So that's what I wanted to make sure that we cover here. So let me jump right in here and bring this up so you guys can actually see as far as the long-term positions that I have and some of the companies that I am looking at. So the first one that I have here on my list is Social Capital. So again, this one is the ticker symbol IPOE. I like this one because they are in the process of taking SoFi public. So SoFi is a social finance app that helps people to manage their money. I mean, holistic money management, this company provides it, SoFi provides it. So IPOE is planning to take them public. The way I see this particular company, to me, it's the next Square, in my opinion. They do everything when it comes to a money management perspective. So they do loans, they do investing, they do money management, credit card, just name it. It's just like a one-stop shop for people that are looking to manage their money. And their demographic is specifically millennials, which they love because they're using the app. They don't have to deal with people. So I really like this one. And so I bought this, I think it's about $15. It's pulled back and I'm not even worried about it. I'm adding more as I see the pullback because this is definitely a long-term play in my opinion. The second one here is NIO. Again, NIO has gone up to close to about $70 before pulling back. Again, NIO to me is one of those plays where down the road, they are going to explode. I'm not worried about NIO. I'm holding NIO long-term because I see the opportunity there. So I'm gonna keep adding to NIO and I have no fear on that. And then we move on to Churchill Capital. Again, this is one that people got so disappointed because when they announced that they were going public with their merger, you know, with Lucy Moto, everybody thought the price of the stock was going to go up, but the reverse happened. The price of the stock rather went down. So you're thinking to yourself, like, what happened? It's just because of the way that merger was actually structured, because I think Churchill only owns about 16-point-something% of Lucy Moto. And so people were not super excited. Wall Street wasn't excited about that until the merger goes through. And then that's where you would see this, the actual stock price is going to really balance up. But I don't really care. For me, I'm looking 4 or 5 years down the road, so I'm adding more as I see the opportunities. I bought more when it dropped down to 27, and I'm gonna keep adding. Again, my goal is to hold this thing long term. This is not a swing trade or just a quick flip. So again, I want you guys to be aware of that. And then we move on to this one is Torchlight Energy Resource. I've covered this particular stock here on the channel, and I've told you guys why I'm buying it, because they are merging with Meta Material, which is a nano material producing company, which I think as the future of really coming up with these durable, less heavy materials that can be serviced in all sort of industries, from airline industries to even just transportation. So I like this one. Again, the pullback here gives me an opportunity to continue to build my position in the stock. So, and then last but not the least is KULR technology, guys. I talked about this company here, and this one in particular is over the counter. So this is OTC, just so you guys are aware. I talked about this company here on the channel, and because I saw what they were doing, this company provides a technology that protects batteries. If you think about the batteries that we have in electric vehicles today, or any technology that's powered by a battery, that batteries get impacted by temperature. So if it's too hot, the battery can explode. If it's too cold, the battery doesn't perform as it would. So these guys, the technology really protects that battery in really hot or cold conditions and keep the battery safe and keep the battery operating efficiently. So they actually partner with NASA to protect the battery that is on the rover that just got to Mars. So to me, this is a company that's up and coming, and I see a bright future in them. So I keep adding to my position. Even though so far, this pullback hasn't really impacted the stock. Like, if you can see today, the stock is up 21%, which is kind of crazy. You think like, hey, the market is pulling back. Why is this company going up? So, but again, this is one that I like. And when I see each of the dips down here, as you can see here, I keep adding to my position. This one, I'm looking, once all this settle, this stock is going to run huge. And I'm not selling one share of this one. I'm going to hold this one for a while before I even consider taking off some positions. But for now, I'm actually adding more to my position. So there you go, guys. Those are five stocks that I'm actually looking at right now during this period. I'm adding to my position again, guys. These are my stocks, and I believe in these companies. It doesn't necessarily mean that you should just go buy them. You have to do your own research and be comfortable with where you put your money. These ones are stocks that I'm looking for 5, 10 years down the road. I don't plan on selling them anytime soon. For stocks that I'm actually looking at swing trading, that's different. My strategy there would be different. But the ones that I'm actually looking at long term, I don't really care. When I see a dip, I add. When I see a dip, I add. And that's just the way that works for me. So let me know in the comment section, what stocks have you been buying or adding to your position during this dip in the market? Let me know again in the comment section. If you're new to the channel, we talk about how to earn money, how to save money, how to invest and build wealth. So if that's something that interests you, go ahead and hit that subscribe button and your notification bell so you don't miss out on new content. Also, guys, if you're looking to get started with investing, WeBull has the promotion where if you sign up and deposit $100, you get free stocks. Links in the description below. And as always, guys, do your due diligence. Don't be a greedy savage and stay motivated.